Grandpa had all the equipment twice. He's now has it in the nursing home. Because the nursing home got flooded. So, just praying for him. Remember Mildred, she's now getting her therapy right at Urban. She's in her therapy at Urban. Remember her. Who else? Remember all the blood victims? There's a lot of them. People are homeless. Trying to clean up their homes. Good to see all these smiling children. So my little girl better be keeping here. She's not night sleep. She can be here 3 weeks. Well, you're supposed to be bringing her. I just messaged you back, Slash. You said, yeah. Anybody else?
Stay up. Y'all pray for Adie and Debbie. And pray for my sis and him, dog. The Lord answered a prayer for me there. And pray for all the homeless people. And just pray for everybody in the whole United States of America. Even the ones that are back there hid in the crack. Pray for them too.
Lisa's super excited that she has all these children in Sunday school. She's
excited
herself. She's ready.
I tried to find about a 20-pound box of chocolate, but nobody didn't have any.
Thank you, we appreciate it. I'm sure they still have to get them all out.
That's some red bull.
Some people don't believe it.
Y'all have Ernie knows all about that. He used to hop our children up on it. He had Carlos hopped up one night. He was jumping straight up and down on the bed. Me and I already just crashed and come down and went to sleep. That's how bad it was. And he thought it was funny. All right, anybody else? Before we pray. Bobby's a little stressed. She's been triaging until late, and I think her phone is ready to fall. All right, now last night, thank you. Remember the service.
Amen.
Father God, Lord, we praise you this morning, Lord. Lord, we ask that you just take over this service today, Father. We ask that you just come in and have your way. Touch each and every heart that's here, Lord, and every request that has been brought before you this morning.
Yes, Father God.
We know you're able, and we thank you for moving in each and every situation. Touch every heart that's here, every mind that's here, Father. We pray for those that couldn't be here this morning. Send your ministering angels, Father, to touch them in body and mind and spirit, Father, and we'll never fail to give you the praise, the honor, and glory for it all. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Thank you.
The King is coming. Hosanna, he's on his way. Hosanna, the King of Israel. Hosanna, he's on his way.
Set free, there is a Never in the water, and he's holding back.
that's pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you. What matters is what God says we are. And He says He loves us. And anytime we're willing, He's ready to accept us into His kingdom.
What was the first name?
Thank you. Thank you.
Heavenly Father, we're gracious that you allow us to be in your house this morning. Lord, we pray for all the water victims, the flood victims, anybody that was affected through this storm, Lord. We ask that you protect us all from the blessings of the good will. In the Lord's name.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Respect of one, for I have learned in whatsoever state I am, therewith to be content. I know both how to be abased, and I know how to abound. Everywhere and in all things I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to be abound and to suffer need. I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. Father God, Lord, I praise you this morning, Lord. Lord, I need your strength, and I need you to move in me so I can bring forth this message, Lord. Don't let me say a word that's about me. It's all about you and the kingdom of heaven this morning. Hide me behind the cross. And Lord, you take over and speak through me to your people. And I'll never fail to give you the praise, the honor, and the glory for it all. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. So I want you to understand one thing about the book of Philippians. Paul was in prison. As he was writing these words.
Amen.
Do you understand that no matter what state you're in or what you're going through, you can be a blessing to someone else?
Yeah.
No matter what's going on in my life, I should be able to reach out to any of you and help you. Amen? So Paul's in prison, and it wasn't just a small prison state, Jen. He'd been there for 2 years. 2 years held captive. And he still continues to write letters of encouragement to the churches that he started to work with. And in this particular scripture, he's telling them that no matter what state you're in, whether you're up, whether you're down, whether you're hungry or whether you're full, whether you've got it to give or whether you don't, you should be content. You know why? Because you have Jesus. And Jesus is all you need. Amen? He is the bread of life.
Yes.
He is the living water.
Amen.
So what else do we need?
Come on.
We look for satisfaction in too many other places, church.
Bless you all.
We get disgruntled with the way things are going. We're unsatisfied. And we start looking to other directions. But Jesus is saying, look to me.
Yeah.
I can satisfy you. I have everything you need.
Yes.
If you seek me first, everything you need will be given unto you. I can honestly say in my walk that I've never done without. I got a little low sometimes. Got a little scary sometimes. But he's always there, Mikey. He's always there. So no matter if I'm taking my last bite, I should be content. No matter what else is going on, because if I am completely sold out to him, then he's got me.
Yeah.
Amen? Then no matter what I'm going through, I should be happy. I should be satisfied. What is the definition of content? The adjective is to be in a state of peaceful happiness. If I'm a Christian, I got joy unspeakable.
Full of glory.
I got a smile on my face the devil can't knock off. So no matter what my bank account says, or what my refrigerator says when I open the door, I should be full of happiness. Enjoy, right?
Amen.
The verb Content means to satisfy. The noun means to be in a state of satisfaction. I found what I've been looking for. Have you found what you've been looking for this morning?
Come on.
Because if you're not satisfied in your situations and in your life, then you need to come up here and get a little farther.
Yeah.
Because he satisfies.
Yes.
Paul said, I can be content in all circumstances. No matter what's going on. I'm tied up in prison.
Come on.
I'm tied up in prison. But I'm satisfied. And I'm going to tell you, you can be satisfied too if you know this man named Jesus.
Yes.
Right? Because no matter if you're hungry, he satisfies. No matter if you're full, he satisfies. And there's no indigestion with that, right, guys? You can't get too much of it. Go over to the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 6. You have the verse 31. This is Jesus speaking here, and he says, therefore take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or withal shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that you have need of all these things. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Take therefore no thought for tomorrow. The morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. There's enough going on around today. Don't be worried about tomorrow. God knows what we need, and if we're seeking him, then he's going to make sure those things are in place. Amen?
Hallelujah.
Y'all quiet this morning. Let's go a little farther. Let's go over to 1 Timothy. You can find it, Jeff. I got it back to me. I hear you mumbling and complaining. 1 Timothy 6, verse 6. Y'all all right back there?
Yeah.
Okay, just check. Are you there, Jeff?
Yeah.
Okay. Verse 6 says, but godliness with contentment is great gain. For we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. And having food and raiment, let us be there with content. I got food, clothes on my back. I got Jesus. That's all I need. That's what he's telling us here. We came into this world with nothing. We came into this world naked, and we'll leave here with nothing, right?
Amen.
But what's waiting on us when we leave this world? That's the things we need to be contemplating on, right?
Yeah.
We shouldn't be worried about what John's got over here, and we don't have it. We should be worried about what I'm lacking in my heavenly mansion in heaven. I should be worried about a few more stones in my crown that I'm going to lay in my Savior's feet. These are the things that we need to be going after. These are the things we need to be seeking.
Yes,
amen?
Amen.
Not worldly things. The world wants us. Oh, the world wants us. But the world has got nothing to give us, Ernie.
Amen.
But destruction. The world will destroy us. Material things will destroy us.
Amen.
So we need to be seeking after the kingdom of heaven and leaving all that junk alone.
Amen.
Let's go a little further. That they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare, and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which will some coveted after. They have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. Let's talk about some downfalls we read about in the Bible. Let's talk about Lucifer first. He wasn't satisfied, was he? He wanted more. He was full of pride, and he felt like a lot of our young people in this day and time feel like, that he was entitled to more. That's what society is teaching right now. You are entitled to something, Scott. Now, I've taught on this before. You are entitled to do whatever you want to do. You are entitled to walk this walk with with Jesus, or you are entitled to run wild and go to hell.
Come on, preach.
You are entitled to get up in the morning, if you're able, and go to work. Whatever job you choose. Then you will get a paycheck that you are entitled to, and then you can spend that paycheck. When it comes to our faith and our walk with Jesus, He already did everything that He needed to do.
Yes, He did.
We got what we were entitled to. We didn't deserve it, first of all. We didn't deserve it, Snowden. What He done for us, we didn't deserve. But He done it anyway. And He gave it to us freely. Now it is our job, Scotty, to grab a hold of it and do something with it. Or to sit on it. And not be content with ourselves. We'll always be looking for something more. When I was out running, I was always looking for something more.
Come on.
I couldn't find it in a bar. I couldn't find it in a man. But I tried.
Come on.
I found it right here at the altar.
Yeah.
That's when I found satisfaction for my life. You see, because there's a hole if He's not there.
Yeah.
Because He belongs there.
Yeah.
He died for each and every one of us. He belongs in our lives. He is our Lord and Savior.
Amen.
He created us.
Yeah.
To worship Him and to work for Him. So if you're not doing that, there's a hole, Sister Margaret, that's in your life that you will never, ever, ever, I don't care where you go, where you've been, who you're with, who you're looking for, it will never be filled until Jesus moves in.
Amen. That's good preaching.
Because that is where our true contentment comes from.
Yes.
You see, we're not born with contentment, Scotty. It's not something we learn, Lindsay. It's something we choose.
Amen.
I choose to be content because I have Jesus. I choose to be happy because He is in my life. I choose to serve Him, Ida, because of what He's done for me. And in return, He fulfills. He satisfies the longings. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Let's talk about another one, David. David was a man after God's heart. Thank God, God's merciful. Because David wasn't satisfied with what he had in his home. He went to another man's home looking.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen?
And what happened?
Come on.
It caused a lot of problems in it.
Yep. Amen.
But thank God, God's merciful.
Yes.
Thank God He has mercy and grace that He extends to us each and every day. Because if we mess up, all we got to do is face up and say, I'm sorry. And if we truly repent, He forgives us of that, Ida.
Yeah.
And then we can return back into His safety, back into His love, back into contentment and satisfaction. Amen? What about Adam and Eve? A lot of people were blaming on Eve, but I guess she started it, didn't she? Because that serpent whispered in her ear and said, there's something more that you don't know. So she was no longer satisfied with what she had. She wanted to know more.
Come on.
So she took the apple, or whatever fruit it was forbidden, and she took it back to Adam. Ate this. He was right there with her. He chose. He knew better. But they lost their satisfaction when the enemy began to whisper in her ear to tell them that there was more to it. That they needed to go looking for more. When God had already provided everything they needed. Amen? So if you find yourself looking for more, come to the altar. If you find yourself not satisfied, come to the altar. Because I guarantee you, if you are true about it, He will meet you there. And He will fill that void in your life. Amen? All right, let's go to Hebrews. Go a little farther over here, Jeff. Towards the back of the book. Hebrews 13. All right, Hebrews 13, starting in verse 6. No, verse 5, sorry. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. For He has said, I will never leave thee, nor forsake thee. so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man shall do unto me. Do you ever think since you already let us give a little down so he can get some glory out of it?
Come on.
Does he get any glory out of when everything's going okay? That's easy to glorify then. But I'm talking about when you're down to your last morsel, Jeff.
Come on.
Praise God. Remember the widow woman in 1 Kings? God sent Elijah. He'd been hiding out. And the brook where he was drinking had run dry. And he told him, he said, go to this widow woman. She'll feed you. So when he gets there, he asks her for a drink of water and a little cake. And she proceeds to tell him, I was just getting ready to go in and use the last of my flour and the last of my oil. Feed it to me and my son, and then we will die. It's all she had left. And Elijah said, you go make me a cake first, and I guarantee you that God will supply. She trusted him. She went on in. She made that cake. She brought it to him, and he ate it. And she never done without it.
Amen.
She never done without. Why? Because she trusted in the one. She trusted in the one that could do all things.
Yeah.
She trusted in the one that parted the Red Sea. She trusted in the one that fed them in the wilderness, day in and day out, when food just fell from heaven.
Hallelujah.
Where is your trust at today? Because you can't have this contentment that I'm talking about if your trust is not in him. Amen? So that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper. What a testimony when you go in and you make the last of what you have and you feed it to a man of God and then God decides you will never do without. What a testimony when you have the last of what you have and someone knocks on your door and says, here, God sent you here. Put your trust in the one that can make a sinner walk up to you and lay money in your hand.
Yeah.
He can do all things and we can do all things because he is in us.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. We don't have to fear. We don't have to worry. Amen? So when I begin to think about how I used to go here and there, looking for this, looking for that, and my loved ones praying for me to come home. So if you're here today, and you haven't fully surrendered, let me give you a word of advice. Surrender now. Take it from somebody that knows. You don't want to hear it from me. Sister Bobby can let you know. Just go ahead. Come on in here and say, Lord, here I am. Before it happens. Before you find yourself up against a brick wall with nowhere to go.
Amen.
And trust me, it ain't pretty.
No, it ain't.
It's not pretty. Young people, you better stay where you're at. Because you got praying parents.
Yep.
You got praying people all around you that's praying for you.
Amen.
You better stay where you're at or you'll face the music. I'm not trying to threaten you. I'm just trying to be nice and warn you.
Yep.
Because when I hit my rock bottom, I hit my rock bottom. I couldn't go no farther, Ida. I didn't have an ounce of respect for nobody. Didn't have a smile on my face or love in my heart for anybody. I didn't care what was going on. It was me and me. That was it. I was going to go to the bars. I was going to dance. I was going to drink. I was going to do whatever I wanted to do. And one of these days, I would surrender. Well, guess what? God said different. God said, listen here. He said, I've got you now. You got nowhere to go. But down on your knees, crying out and begging for forgiveness. So I beg of you now, if you have not done this, please come forward and do it. Please come forward and do it, because every one of you sitting in here, I'm praying for you. Every one of you that's sitting in here, I'm praying for your children. Every one of you that's sitting in here, I'm praying for your brothers and sisters. And if they ain't saved, they're going to be saved.
Hallelujah.
Because that's what we're all about here at Full Gospel Evangelistic Ministry. Because Jesus is our leader. He is our head. And he's still saving, Ernie.
Yeah.
That is his main thing, to save souls from hell. So it is our job here at Full Gospel Evangelistic Ministry to preach about Jesus. And to preach that he is the only way to heaven. There is no ifs, ands, buts about it. So if you have not surrendered to him, surrender. If you're watching on Facebook this morning and you have not surrendered, just know him is not enough. You got to give him your heart. You got to give him everything you got. You got to show up for him. You got to be there for him. You got to work for him.
Hallelujah.
And then, on Judgment Day, when I stand before him content and fully satisfied, and he says, enter in, my good and faithful servant. Satisfaction how the man that died for us. Amen.